I got a phone call from the Falkland Islands from the fisheries department there to say that some fishermen had been out fishing. They pulled up their nets and found an enormous squid. When you're trying to preserve an enormous specimen, it's quite a big task. So I had to call in favours from curators all over the museum. I think there was between about 13 and 20 people at any time helping me. Such a rare and unusual specimen, I really wanted to get it right.
I've been working here for over 40 years now, but it's still a very exciting job. Nature throws up surprises. We have to respond when a specimen becomes available.
What Ollie actually did was slit the specimen along the stomach and inject chemicals right into the centre and sort of bathe the organs almost in formal saline. And this really helps to fix the specimen from stopping it rotting. It was brilliant because I'd never seen a complete giant squid before. It was pretty smelly. Giant squid have ammonia in their tissues, which is released when they die, and that smells a little bit like urine. So yeah, it was a pretty grim day, but amazing to have preserved a specimen like this to put on display here at the museum. I think one of the most difficult challenges was finding a way of displaying the specimen. We really wanted people to be able to come in behind the scenes and see the giant squid. In the end, we ended up contacting Damien Hirst people and finding out who built their tanks for his kind of cows and sharks in formalin. And that's the company we ended up going with in the end. She's actually the largest wet preserved specimen that we've ever preserved here. She's 8.62 meters in length. We have over 80 million specimens here in the Natural History Museum, and over 20 million of those are kept here in the museum's spirit collection.
Although the spirit collections are stored behind the scenes at the museum, they feel to us like quite the core of the collections. So it's exciting that members of the public can also look around the spirit collection.
Most of the sharks, though, you can see